Big ups to the fam. Shouts out to the team. Welcome to the Rhymes Podcast. If it's your first time rocking with us, make sure to like, share, and subscribe. If you've been rocking with us, then you already know what it is. Full Rhymes, mainstream news, pop culture, a little bit of family business. I'm your host, Benjamin Esgood. As always, got my Rhymes rocking with me. Today, we got the brothers LeBlanc. Got Kurt, who we call Fact Checker. We got Jew, a.k.a. Nino.
What's up, everybody?
I'm cooling like a smoothie, dog. If y'all don't mind, fellas, long day today. Fingers are off. I can't do it without doing it. You know what I'm saying? Just bear with us for 1 second. Let's do that, y'all.
Yes, sir.
What's up? Round Podcast. What's up? It's a comedy game. We're kicking it right here at the Legends Concert. All the legends, you feel me? I'm a legend. I'm a young legend. You know, Rockin' Rhymes Podcast, you old wrong shit.
If you like the content, make sure you like, share, and subscribe.
Real shit, only fuck with them niggas I'm still with. I still with, if I'm in a fix, they buy some trill shit. For my rounds, I peel shit, devise plans to get a meal ticket. With that attitude, like we'll get it, still busy. Still with it, looking over haters like they little midgets. Noisy hopping around the night, camouflage like little crickets. I got a problem with me having just a little digits. From the city where niggas lie and kill, and steal for riches. And I done been around and even met some trill bitches. Broads hard in these niggas, real snitches. I never tell on the soul, that's cold, a real sickness. Love run deep, I won't speak with God as my witness. I never mix with fake niggas because it's bad for business. And when I eat off my plate, I eat off clean dishes. That's why I'm testing my faith, about to get on my mission. It's real over here, daddy, so won't you take a listen. My nigga, my nerd, my partner, my ward and my round. My ace and my dog, my ride or die, my all the way down, nigga. My nigga, my nerd, my partner, my ward and my round. My ace and my dog, my ride or die, my all the way down, nigga. My nigga, my nerd, my partner, my ward and my round. My ace and my dog, my ride or die, my all the way down, nigga. My nigga, my nerd, my partner, my ward and my round. My ace and my dog, you heard me.
Keep my circle slim and grass trim. Can't let the serpents in. I circumvent crab niggas. Could get you murked for years.
All right, that's a little better. Big ups to the fam. Shouts out to the team. As I said before, your boy Benjamin Ness is the Rhymes Podcast. If you've been rocking with us, you should know the format. If you haven't been rocking with us, y'all make sure y'all like, share, and subscribe. And what we give y'all is full rounds, mainstream news, pop culture, a little bit of family business. We the home of the top four, known for the mix. Bam, Kurt Dog, check it. Jew, a.k.a. Hatchet. What's good with your hat, fellas?
Hatchet Dallas.
What's going on, man?
Hey, bro, I'm trying to get right.
Another day on the third plane, you
feel me?
I know that's right, bro. Shouts out to the chat, Ms. Minor. Evening to you. All y'all were rocking with us. Appreciate the tune in. Like us say, all y'all gotta do is like us. We love y'all. And fellas, I'm a little off it, but we gonna get to it. If y'all ready to get to it, I got the top four locked and loaded. I think it's a little better than last time. And with that being said, let's get it.
You could give me one good reason why I should believe you, even all the things that you tell. I would sure like to believe you, my heart wants to receive you, just make me know that.
I need somebody I'm living.
them good old 90s, y'all. Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Good old
90s. That was a nice lineup.
Yeah, it was.
That was a little better than, hard. You know, the last time trying to bounce back a little bit. We want the order of songs, top four. Give me your top four songs, and then I want the artist, bro. You know what I'm saying? And need some heavy hitters out the 90s. So, Kurt, we start with you at the top. I'll have it.
Oh, man. So I'm not as thorough as my man Hatch. Man, Hatch be coming with it. I'm not going to give I'm going to give him his props. Put
the pressure on y'all.
I know, right? So, man, I got some sweet spots, right? So I'm going to say, like, I used to vibe off of Mary J. going to school every day when I was in high school. Like, you know, I had, well, I don't say every day, but I had the Walkman with the CD. So, you know what I'm saying? That 411 was hitting, right? So that's that was part of the whole thing. So just the vibe and the up-tempo, you know, I'm going to say that Mary J. is probably going to be my, if I just want to, you know, get something to groove to, I'm going to probably go with her. Then I will say it's going to be my Janet Jackson. Janet Jackson is, you know, that one where you sit down and vibe to, you know, the softness of her voice, the, you know, sultriness. You know, I think that she delivers her style of music is pretty decently. She has her space. And then I'm going to go with, I'm going to say Mariah Carey, only because Mariah has some, again, you know, she has some range, right? She could go from some of the singy stuff to some of the, you know, nice groovy stuff you can kind of listen to around your family. And, you know what I'm saying? Just some stuff that you could kind of go with. So I'm going to go with Mariah Carey. And then, I mean, she do got pipes, right? So her ability there is, the range is just crazy, right? But the music that she does just doesn't always fit to me. But anyway, and then Toni Braxton. I put Toni last only because of the fact that nothing against her ability to sing in any way, shape, or form, and nothing against the way she looks either. It's just more of a, she just seemed like she kind of was, I don't know, she just wasn't properly placed, right? She just didn't get her, I mean, I know she had the views, she had the following, she made the money, lost the money, you know, but she just didn't kind of stick with me the same way as the other ones did. You know, so that's my top four. Yeah, you know, I think she could have, but it's just, I don't know what it was about, what lifestyle, how everything worked out for her, whatever.
I got you. Shouts out to G-Man. Shouts out to Brendan Hatch. Holla at me. What you got?
Man, it's fucking windbag, man. Fucking up, boy.
I knew you were going to come with it, man. Come on.
Oh, hold a second. Hold a second. Let me just tell us. All right. Look. So, these are some heavy hitters, right? When we're talking about the 90s. I'm gonna say all them icons, right?
Yes, sir.
I mean, that's easily put. And then, okay, we'll start with the songs. All right. So, what Mariah's best song? So, I can't put a top, right?
We're not talking about.
It's not our top song. That's right. That ain't the 90s. That happened in 2000.
Gotcha.
So I put her last because of the song choice, right?
Okay.
Janet Jackson is Janet Jackson. This is Janet Jackson. This is Janet Jackson. This is not Jermaine Jackson. This is Janet Jackson. Right? And that was a fire-ass song. But it wasn't her top song during that time. So I'm going to put Janet third. So I got Mariah at the bottom. I got Janet third because of the song. And then second, I'm going to go with Mary J. She ruled the whole shit. Puffy did it right. You know what I'm saying? It was probably one of the best things he ever did. That and Jodeci. You feel me? He had her on the right track. It was street. It was gritty. She was doing a lot of songs that everybody already knew. You know what I'm saying? So right out the gate, they singing her shit. She got some swag to it. She couldn't really sing that well at the time, but she was 100% swag, like Monica. You see what I'm saying? It was just what it was. Right. Now, I put her number two. Now, when I say 100% swag, that's Toni Braxton. When the bitches had their hair all down their back and all this stuff, Toni little short, fine thing came with the bald fucking head, haircut. All the bitches cut their hair.
I still remember when Nikki came to the dance with that fucking short haircut.
Come on, man. Come on, man. Look, when Toni Braxton hit the streets, boy, it was over. She had a deep, sultry voice. She was super cute. You know what I'm saying? Kind of exotic looking, fresh face, and a fresh fucking sound. You mean the world to me. Come on, man. That song popped like a motherfucker. Boomerang soundtrack. Halle Berry, everybody got put on with the short haircut because of fucking Toni. So I say she won the 90s, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? So that's what it is. Now, who the best artist? Janet Jackson. She got the best resume. Mariah Carey, she got a hell of a fucking catalog. She's a cult classic with the fucking Christmas songs and all of that shit. Everybody know what it is. I don't wanna lie for, you know what time that is. Man, Mary J is Mary J. She's probably, you know what I'm saying, she's not as good as an entertainer as I say Mariah Carey is. I mean, not Mariah Carey, she's not a good entertainer at all. Janet Jackson is. But she still got the love of the streets, and she always got the love of the streets. Yeah. Toni Braxton is a fucking Grammy winner, you know what I'm saying? Extraordinaire. She has a hell of a catalog, too, and she won the 90s. So ain't no losers here. Everybody did their thing.
Oh, yeah. Agreed.
This is a good one. This is a good one, right, Chip?
Yeah. I'm a, shit. It is a tough lineup. So I'm going to go with we talked about song first, so to me, I'm gonna go with that Mary J. Right, that's my top four as the song. Then I'll go with song wise, we'll do Janet second. Third would be it's hurting, brother. It's all good. They all good. So I don't know. To put it in the category for me would be like, I don't know. It's like putting it in a box. Like you can't really. But we'll go Toni last. Mariah Carey third. Song choice. Artistry, I'm gonna definitely go Janet Jackson. She one of the top because of, you know, the ground she's set and everything else for women and R&B and pop and everything. So just her artistry period across the board is ridiculous. Dance moves, all that shit, and sexuality, and she, you know, but yeah, shit. I leave it there, bro. I just leave it there. I'll leave it there.
Say, dog. I mean, on this one, you know, a lot of agreement. It's a, you know, it's a good choice of songs and artists. So, real quick for me, song, Mary J, then Janet. Dog, the Dream Lover, not the best song, dog, but I like that motherfucker. If Janet and Mary J wasn't in there, I'd probably be them bumped it up. You know what I'm saying? Because it's one of, dog, back in the G, to me, the fillers, the quote-unquote fillers, the album songs, not necessarily the singles, but the fillers, right. The meat of the shit, I hate the love. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I like that song. Last week on Toni, And Toni's song probably better, but I'm a funny nigga, so I'm gonna put that Dream Lover third. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
As far as the best artist, everybody that said it. We got Janet.
Yeah.
I'm going Mariah second. Yeah. Just because of the pipes. Like, to me, Mary been around forever. You know what I'm saying? And we could argue about the relevancy. You know what I'm saying? But Mariah got the pipe, so you got to put the pipe second. Then we going Mary. Then we going Tony. Similar to what you were saying, Kurt. A dog with it definitely set the trend, like you saying. Had like I say, I still remember in high school when the bros came with the short haircut to the dance.
Ain't nobody
you know
never. Ain't nobody wore their hair like Mariah Carey.
Hey, but that's cultural. But I mean, I feel like you though, dog. She ain't had a career, Tony, necessarily that the rest of them had. Yeah. For whatever reason, talented as fuck, cute, like yeah. You said.
I don't believe that to be true that. Because she took on a whole different thing with the Braxtons, and so you know what I'm saying, she was able to transcend, still be, you know what I'm saying, relevant as far as entertainment industry.
I don't know, man. I think she was only boxed into, you know, one demographic, to be real with you.
Sometimes when you go reality TV, depending on how Birdman, you do it.
She married Birdman, bro. What is y'all talking about?
Exactly. She married Birdman. Yeah.
Listen, no matter what you may think of Brian Williams in the entertainment industry, he's top five.
Oh yeah, nigga can't knock Bird, man.
All right, so shit, I mean, what?
As far as the show, let your sister them do that shit.
Yeah, I mean, but hey, it ain't no Braxtons without Tony, bro. It's just a bunch of broads.
Look, it's a fat ass do the show. You see what I'm saying? Your cute ass at the house.
I think one of the sisters passed away, I believe.
Oh man!
Yeah, I'd say something. Okay. I believe so too.
Yeah, so it was hard. It was the tall, goofy one, and then it was.
And that was really the way for the get the little what her name is, Tay Maw. That was yeah. you jump off. You dig? Like,
the crazy.
Yeah, look.
The one who really could sing.
Extra face ass. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
She really could sing, bro. I think she has the best voice out of all of them. I think she sound better than Mariah Carey. Mariah Carey just got a higher register. I don't really think Mariah Carey like. Cutting up, like, you know, saying that she could hit some high notes and shit, and that's all good, you know. Right. She's a flute. The bitch can't play the flute, like, you know, saying she, you know, saying it's all good though.
Nick say, hell of a songwriter though. You heard me? Right.
Who?
Yeah.
Who?
Mariah.
Yeah. Boy, tell me two songs Mariah wrote. Tell me two songs Mariah wrote.
Fact checker, get on it for me, baby. We about to get around one.
Look, Mariah came in the game married to Tommy Mottola. Mm-hmm. You understand what I'm saying? Mariah got put on.
I thought that happened after she got into the game, man.
Man, what, the she got in the game.
Marriage to.
No, she married.
Nah, she come in the door with that boy.
Come on, man.
Yeah, she come in the door with that boy.
I thought I saw the movie partially. I just can't remember.
No, people put a lot of shit in movies.
Yeah, I'm about to tell you.
But look, ain't nobody had 1,000 motherfuckers on stage moving at the same time like Janet. Like,
That's why she number one on everybody's list, nigga.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, hell yeah.
And like Juvis say, sexuality, you know, I know y'all be seeing how she be strapping them bars to them fucking gurneys, you heard me? Having shitting on herself.
Man, when she released that video,
we seen how she put them titties out for the Super Bowl.
That was a wardrobe malfunction, allegedly.
My bad.
Yeah.
Justin got too aggressive.
Yeah.
Good shit, fellas.
She was ready, though. She had the jewelry, the nipple jewelry, and everything on that mouth. She was ready.
Boy.
Hey. Icon, you heard me?
Yeah.
Hey, look, 20
she like,
years
I ago. Stay ready. Man. 20 years ago. What's going on after this show?
Yeah.
Taylor Swift. Look, Taylor Swift wish you, bitch, you could.
Stromile Swift and the Swift.
The let's thing, beast thing.
Hey, man. Good shit, fellas. Let's fire this bitch up. You heard me? For Drew, a.k.a. Nino, hashtag of the ENT, Kurt Dog, myself. Benjamin, that's good. Shouts out to Cuzzo. It's the Browns podcast.
You mean no world to me.
This is the shocking moment the Francis Scott Key Bridge collapses after being hit by a huge container ship. As videos emerge online from live streams and passers-by, CNN has looked into exactly what happened. The ship in question is Dali, a 984-foot Singaporean container ship that was heading to Colombo, Sri Lanka, with two pilots on board, the ship's management company says. Using Marine Traffic, a public ship tracking platform, we identified Dali, the ship, as it set off at midnight 50 a.m. in the morning. It follows a straight path towards the bridge until 1:26 a.m. when it starts veering off course. Shortly after it crashes, rescue boats can be seen rushing to the scene. We match this route to what we see in the live stream. Shortly before it veers off course at 1:24 a.m., we see here the ship's lights going out before coming back on seconds later. At 1:25 a.m., we see large plumes of smoke coming from the ship. Then the lights go out again at 1:26 a.m. It indicates a power failure. The crew on board did notify authorities of a power issue, according to the governor of Maryland. Just before the bridge collapses, vehicles can be seen on the bridge. But as the Mayday call goes out, luckily the traffic stops before further tragedy hits. Still, as the search for survivors continues, Baltimore City Fire Department have since confirmed that their sonar have detected vehicles in the water. The ship had in fact crashed before. The port of Antwerp in Belgium tells CNN back in 2016 when it was manoeuvring out of a port, it crashed. The report said it suffered damages in the stern and transom. Now, with official investigations beginning, the question will be whether mechanical or human error caused this.
Fellas, y'all know on these, I really don't necessarily like to touch these per se. We all saw what happened on the Scott Key Bridge. And I don't know what other information y'all had besides what you heard in the clip. But just give me your thoughts after hearing all what I've heard. I'm kind of lost because I'm getting mixed stories. But I'm going to let y'all speak on it. I'll chime in and then we could press on. Right. Jude, what you got?
I was just looking at this earlier, man. There are some people breaking down some videos, just like they did with the levee and 9/11, and they were saying certain things. Was
conspiracy?
Yeah, you know, okay. They saw some explosions. But I'm thinking, hey, there are electrical things and stuff, you know, on the bridge as well. So once that's tampered with, you know, damaged, then you can have all kind of explosions. But could be. It's a tragedy, man. It's tragic, and you know, prayers go out to the families, you know, people that lost family members. But yeah, it's still out there. They're still doing some research, I guess, figuring out what's going on. They also said about the traffic of bringing products and stuff back and forth on that bridge. I mean, that's gonna make it hard for, you know, the economy as well. So you got a lot of things that's been affected. I think it's also three bridges that was down in one day. So I'm not sure if it was the same state, of course, but yeah, it's a lot of weird shit going on right now. That's what I said.
That's Stradamus.
Okay. So I watched it a few times, and everything is not adding up, but the more I get information, it's kind of becoming clear. See, about 10 years ago, there was a survey done by the Army Corps of Engineers, right? And they were talking about the highways and the bridges. A lot of these bridges are 60, 70 years old. They are way past the time that the expectancy. But you know what I'm saying? The culture in transportation kind of picked up technology. There's way more cars and, you know what I'm saying, big trucks and, you know, transpo and shit. They haven't had time to redo all of these things. Right? You can go look, and there's already bids for these projects to be done. Like I'm sure you can go look and find that this Francis Scott Key Bridge has been up for bid to do this, the renovations or the build. All this shit is planned out. Now, do I think it was sabotage? I think that's evidence that could give a case for that. But I also do like, you know, looking at the actual boat, right? Or the vessel. The video mentioned that it had a wreck before, meaning that either the crew and captain is trash, or the vessel itself is a piece of crap. You know, piece of crap. You know what I mean? And we all know, like, when you got a fucked up work vehicle, that bitch gonna go out on you at the worst fucking time. You know what I'm saying? But I do know something about the customs and border patrol and, you know, dudes run a tight ship when it comes to that type of shit, docking and, you know what I'm saying, manifesting who coming in and their record and, you know, shit like that. So I don't really see them letting a piece of shit come dock in there, you know what I'm saying, and you know what I'm saying, and then leave out and fuck up and go into the bridge. I surveyed that area from all angles. That wasn't really a hard, you know what I'm saying, place to leave out. You know what I'm saying? Not like the Industrial Canal to where it's, you know what I'm saying, you got to maneuver and outside. Yeah. It's, you know what I'm saying, a big span for you to get past if you got to turn around or whatever. So it could look kind of deliberate because from you know, my point of view, looked like it kind of made past it and then like kind of turned right to the side and back into the motherfucker.
Right.
And the shit felt like domino. You know what I'm saying? Like it felt kind of like crumbly, like, you know what I'm saying? Like it felt like that. You know what I'm saying? After the traffic went, you know what I'm saying? It just kind of, you know, I don't know.
That's kind of my thing, dog. And I'm gonna let you go, Kurt, for my questions. But that's kind of my shit. Go ahead, bro.
No, I mean, to be honest, I didn't really put nothing past visually what I saw on the news, man. I didn't really give it much thought. I know there's a lot going on, you know, with conspiracy theories, people using equipment that's outdated. I mean, you know, I could tell you stories about the military and army alone about how they handled equipment and how long they kept it around. But the point of the matter is, I did feel like it was definitely unfortunate that the people who were working on the bridge doing their day-to-day job, you know what I'm saying, lost their lives. And now their families are without, but I don't know, man. Seeing the clip that you put on there, saw some of the smoke coming out. And
is somebody working on the bridge? That was a drawbridge where they had live people there working on the bridge. I thought it was just a suspension bridge, like any other.
I heard they were doing some repairs on the bridge.
At the time of the accident, in the middle of the fucking night.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you know they got the night crews be getting, I guess, figuring shit be slower. But that's why you
see that. I think you should see the light, the truck. That's why it was so lit up. You know, they be having all those bright lights and stuff when they doing the highways and stuff.
So did they shut down the bridge or not? Because you're saying you shut down the bridge, like right after that 18 where they got through. Oh, they was able to get through. They shut the bridge down, but yet. Per the clip could be off. They saying that sonar got calls down there. And I could have some calls been there. But so if you see what I'm saying? Like, which one is it? Is it just the 8 workers and 2 of them were saved? So it seemed like 6 casualties? Or which one is it?
Put that up there.
So that, you know, that's my only thing, bro. I'm gonna
tell you this
situation, bro. For sure.
Look,
that sonar could have really got something coming off them containers too. It's all kind of shit in them containers.
Yeah, true. I thought a couple of containers fell in there, right?
Yep. Well, I don't know. It probably did.
And then it could have been caused there. Yeah.
Right.
But look, bro, the only way somebody gonna invade this country is if they take out our infrastructure.
But that's a drop in the bucket. Okay. It's gonna be an inconvenience to the drivers and people who commute back and forth. You know what I'm saying? It'll be an inconvenience to them. Now, as far as goods and shit, it's okay, if you got bridge, that means you got water. Your water, you got boats and vessels to get from the other side. That's what they did before. Like, we, that ain't, that shouldn't be nothing to fucking, okay, buy some fucking boats and, you know, like, come on. It's an opportunity to beef up the port and to actually make that harbor something else. You know what I'm saying? Now it's big business happening at the fucking harbor.
That's true.
Again, like,
oh yeah, oh yeah, no,
you know what I'm saying? Like,
capitalism,
you know, shit gonna go when something fuck up. You know what I'm saying? We smart enough people to do that. I'm just saying, is this gonna be a trend? Like, when does it become a problem, or when does it, or like, are we on high alert now to the other bridges? Not just because it fell down or I had an accident. Like I said, they did surveys years ago that said these things have lasted its lifetime already. Like, should we start, you know what I'm saying, shutting these bitches down voluntarily and making, you know what I'm saying?
At least check.
No, you're raising some good points, because I always wonder about infrastructure like that. Like, you see, you've been riding over this motherfucker a long time yourself. Right. You know what I'm saying? Like, how long has it really been in service? You feel me? And what is the upkeep on it?
Think about coming across the Bonnie Carry. Man, 24/7 motherfuckers, zoom. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Come on, man. That's on piling, sitting in the fucking middle of the goddamn, you know what I'm saying?
Come on, bro.
Take Poncho train and fucking, come on. So it's like, when, how close are we? I mean, when was the last? I mean, that was in the fucking 50s, right? You know what I'm saying?
Come on, man. Yeah,
preach. He did the twin span over there and slide out because the fucking Katrina fucked it up.
Yeah.
But how long niggas riding on that ragged ass bridge? Had to go to back way and smoke shit.
That was a child, bro.
Come on, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? Nigga had to go straight down Chef on the double cross. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think that shit shut down. Nah, but, you know, Versailles Island and all that shit. Like,
man, I be wondering about the other bridges.
It's a lot of them.
They just keep doing repairs on.
What's the one coming out of Baton Rouge?
Repairs.
The back way.
Yeah, you talk about the the back way. I don't know about the back way.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah. I know what you talk about. You talk about the one that goes over the where the people got the swamp boats at.
No, man, coming
not like, 190, not off of 190.
What the fuck? This name of this bridge? Somebody say something. Damn you! Come on, help me out here.
Sunshine Bridge. Yeah.
Take it, Sunshine Bridge.
Look, you could see you could look off the side of that bitch and see the ground, like when you're driving.
It's narrow like a
motherfucker.
Yeah, I'm straight on now.
Yeah,
sounded like with the Huey P.
He was a long bridge. Yeah,
that bitch. That motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Oh,
yeah, come on, goddamn two way, nigga. See, I'm straight on that.
Yeah, sidewalk.
Yeah, buddy. No.
That's a for liar.
A chaff a lot. Boy, where you from, boy? I can't even say you from Metairie or Kenner, because they know better than that.
Metairie.
Hey, man.
Metairie.
Let's go, man.
That's how the football niggas say Metairie.
Metairie.
Why is the borders open, though? Because the United States is in a real tough pickle right now. My generation, we worked hard. I worked for Verizon. But my kids, your generation, y'all not going to do sanitation work, pick up garbage. Y'all not going to be postal workers. Y'all not going to be electricians. You're not going to be plumbers. You're not going to do construction. Y'all starting podcasts. Y'all thinking about other ways of making money. What does that mean if these jobs are not being filled? They create programs for the migrants where they're giving them rent. They're giving them money. In Chicago, they have a program where they give them $9,000 every 6 months. So that's $18,000 a year for rent. That's an average of about $1,500 to $1,300 a month. That's good rent for somebody, right? So now they're living in all these places. Your generation, you, your kids, y'all are not buying houses, bro. So you know what that is? Y'all not getting mortgages. United States needs people to get mortgages. Y'all are not going to college no more. Y'all not creating college debt. United States needs college debt. Y'all are entrepreneurs. Y'all are not joining the military. The military is depleted. That's why they're having things like proxy wars, where they got the drones dropping bombs because they don't have enough military. Y'all are not doing the things that I did, my grandparents did when they came here. So they bringing in millions of new people who are going to do these things.
Oh,
I got us. Yeah, we Backgrounds Podcast. Definitely understand where he's trying to go with it. At the same time, too, I think on certain instances, he's stretching that bitch a little bit. Kurt, we're going to start at the top with you. Swing it down the hat. Hit you.
Hey, bro, I can't go first, bro. Kurt went first.
Yeah, let him go. Let him go first.
Yeah. What we doing?
Yeah,
you want to go first?
I'm going to go first, bro.
Good.
Thank you, bro. That mean a lot, girl. Look, he started off so good, right? Because the main point.
And then the stretch.
It wasn't a stretch, is a lie. You started off because the main point is that immigrants are replacing a lot of homegrown on the labor job, on the trades, you know, that type of shit. Huey Long, man, they know what they're talking about. Over last bridge. So if we not going to welding school no more, right? We not being electricians, we not being, you know, plumbers, pipe fitters, brick masons, right? Some of us have went into tech and some of us are doing that, right? And that occupies some. But some, like he said, are doing, you know, less technical jobs, right? We haven't come that far to where machines have and computers have taken over the labor shit. You always gonna need somebody to swing hammers. That's just the way it goes. So when you have those skills, you always gonna have employment, right? A lot of, I ain't gonna say everybody, you know what I'm saying, but enough has moved out of that force. They don't wanna be, you know, like in Texas, you be fucking hard pressed to see a fucking, a black garbage man. It's all Mexicans and Dominicans now. You know what I'm saying? Like that's a lot of jobs out of brother's mouth. You see what I'm saying? That's a lot of dollars because 10, 20 years ago, they was doing that, right? Look at landscaping. Oh boy, you can't cut no grass around this bitch. $20. You know what I'm saying? 2 acres for $20. They cut them bitches. You know what I'm saying? So
like, yeah, that industry on lock, boy.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Listen, the food truck industry, the taco trucks on every fucking corner. Like, it's a lot of hustles that other people done filled that space in. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, what are we going to do? We all can't be rappers. We all can't be, you know, whatever. So I get the point, but he went off the rail when he said we're not buying houses. That's bullshit. Stats say otherwise. We're not going to college. Shit, my kids in college, niggas graduate. Everybody I know, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's like you making it look like all of us are in the ghetto or in poverty. It's not. Like, it ain't about the poverty. It's about the workforce and the employment going forward. Like, what are we gonna do? Because some of the things you're doing now, AI will replace. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, it's good to have, you know, like newer age jobs or move out and be able to pivot and do other things. But like, some of us got to swing fucking hammers, bro. Some of us got to learn how to wire some shit. Some of us got to learn how to do some shit. Because if it all break down, like, come on.
What we gonna do nothing.
Right. What we gonna do then?
Right.
Fact checker.
Man, I think there's truth in about everything he said, but I think that the way he cut it up and edited and chopped and screwed it was in an essence to push his I guess whatever he was trying his point across. The reason why I say that is because, to piggyback off what Hat said, is that, you know, there's still jobs out there. There's still things that we can be doing. Now, I do agree with him with saying that these folks, they're more driven in living a lifestyle more than making an earning and having an honest, practical living. And I think that with those reasons, a lot of them will shy away from laborious jobs that don't pay as well. which requires more time focused on the task that they're supposed to be doing versus being able to live life. And I think the social aspect of the world, or as America, has kind of pushed our kids and our generation to that. And then the fact that we can make things so convenient, it kind of took a lot of the, you know what I'm saying? And the reason why I'm saying that is because even my own kids, right? Even my own kids have so many conveniences that we didn't have growing up.
Thank you.
They don't, and their world is so virtual that simple things, like I got a toaster oven, bro. I got a toaster oven, and it has three gadgets, or three interacting buttons, two buttons, three buttons, and a dial, okay? The dial functions as another button. So it's four buttons to do everything that this thing can do. And they struggle. They struggle to use it, man. They struggle to play around with it, interact with it. And the reason why I'm saying that is that these kids don't want to do all of that laborious interacting, moving around. They just kind of want to live life and kind of move through. Now, the ones that are progressed with parents who push them forward, you know what I'm saying? They're going to do the entrepreneur thing. They're going to get the jobs that are better, preparing them to have maybe families of their own, to live a life in America or whatever, have conveniences. So, I don't know. It was a lot. I think, again, depending on the context of how you want to put it together, I think majority of what he said is true, but I don't think it's true in the sense of a complete contextual story.
That boy is a windbag too. None of the facts, man.
A garbage man makes anywhere from between, depending on how long you've been in that, you're going to be $32,000 a year, right? That's your starting salary. They average $58,000, just that $60,000 a year. That's a laborious job. You out in the elements, you know what I'm saying? You making 60 grand. 60 grand is not bad. It's not the best as far as being able to do what the social life in America, everybody wants to jet set to different countries and ball out on everything, houses, clothes.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, that's kind of talking about two different things here.
But that's, you got to understand where the motivation comes from, though.
Listen, the bottom line is this. There's people who are coming into this country and who are replacing you in the labor force. You have a choice in the matter.
It's correct.
That's the bottom line. It ain't got nothing to do with what they want to do and all this other stuff. Now, you said what the kids don't want to do. But it's not really up to the kids. Like, you know, if like you have to prepare your children for the, you know what I'm saying, for the next.
Yeah, that's time. Based off how you raising the kids.
Nobody's raising their child to be a laborer in a sense. They always
talk about skills. That way you can become like you when can it, yeah. If a man with two solid trades, he ain't no fucking laborer.
That's the thing, though.
Hold on. It depends on what the job
is. I knew an HVAC guy, right? He had his own business, and he separated from one of the chain HVAC people.
Did it stop him from eating?
No, but he even after so long, because it was just him and the type of jobs that he was able to do that normally he could call in and get, you know, assisted. And what I'm saying to you is that you change the dynamic when you're in a job that requires, you have to be skilled as an HVAC person. You have to know electrician. You have to know AC cooling.
I did HVAC. That ain't no labor intensive shit. Like you running goddamn fucking.
It really just about getting in the magics and shit.
You tapping in.
Well, you messing with the units and you getting in the attics and running.
It only work one way. Yeah, I do that shit every day.
That's tight, man.
Yeah, I'm saying, listen, even with that, you can sub out work. If you a craftsman, like you done did that shit, you know saying, 5 years, you a master. Like you ain't going, like you know what that shit is. You know what I'm saying? Like you go through it, you get your license, you get you an apprentice, you build your business up. You ain't supposed to be no fucking laborer all your life.
But this is the thing, though. Like with the laborer word, it could be taken a lot of ways.
But so, it sounds negative though, don't it?
Right. To, to a certain, yeah, because it sounds like you're at the bottom of the totem pole, and that's not necessarily the case. You know what I'm saying?
Right. I never said that. That's why
I'm not saying you per se. I'm just saying the term.
Okay.
Because both of y'all speaking to different, you know, different facets of the term.
The females, they're going to tell you the bottom.
Oh, hell yeah.
Hey, look.
That's low value right now.
Ultimately, dog, when we talking about blue collar type work, in my opinion, work ethic starts at home.
Yes, sir.
You feel me? You ultimately groom to a certain degree to do blue collar work at the house first. Absolutely. Because that's where you get your first dose of clean this, fix that, do this, do that.
Push your weight.
Either you have a knack for it or not, or you know, you go a different route per education, woo-de-woo. But at the end of the day, it starts there. Now, I would question if we talking about, I guess what he's saying as far as what we do and opposed to what the kids do now, I think it have to do with the need. You know what I'm saying? Like, again, when you start from home with the blue collar, then you get your first job. Your first job is usually blue collar, but at restaurant, grocery store, hardware store, et cetera, if you going that route. Mm-hmm. You don't really need to bag groceries anymore. Everything self-check.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Fast food, not so the opportunity because of the need is not there per se. At the same time, the parents not grooming the children to really do shit.
Right.
You feel me? And now we can go with the everything is quick. Now everybody want it quick. We understand that. At the same time, too, you still have to work to get to the point where you could get shit quick. That's what not being delivered to the kids, in my opinion. So you're looking for everything fast, but you don't understand how to really get it and how it work. You feel me? So that's kind of my spiel.
No, I agree with you 100% because that's – so I tell you a story, and I don't know if Javonna remember this, but we stayed by some family, some relatives who stayed out like in a kind of like a country area, in Lake Charles, right? A country part of Lake Charles. Well, he spent his summer putting up fences around properties. And look, he 10, 12 years old.
Man.
Now, I'm going to tell you what he do for a living. He owns his own construction company,
No shit.
But look, he can rebuild a truck.
But
the point I'm trying to make to you is, I agree with you. I just told you, they can't even figure out 3 or 4 buttons. And then, and to Goody's point, the parents got to teach the kids. Now, hands down, a lot of these parents, you know, me and myself included, we look for convenient ways to spend time with our kids, teaching them and mentoring them. And then hands down, we kind of know we want to give them a way forward that's going to give them a life that we feel will be more convenient. All the while, it's the reason is because we don't want to invest the time, like you said, Hat, in holding them accountable by being the actual, you know what I'm saying, visual model of what they should be doing.
When I was younger, when my son was younger, I'm talking about like under 10. Like, sit your ass here and you're going to watch me do this. Grab that, hand me this, give me this, give me that. He cried, he did, and all, you know, I'm bored. This ain't fun. Boy, I don't give a fuck about boy. You gonna
get it. And that's true. I've been listening, y'all. I'm looking up some stuff too. So the job market, blue collar work has shifted. Job focus is just, it's not the same. When you add technology, different things is going on too. So a lot of us, our old school, we wasn't on that so much. We was on that hard work, get out there, cut the grass, do that. Like you just said, we'll get the hammer, whatever. You know what I'm saying? We make it happen. Now it's like the guy said, I don't agree with him. We going to school. It's just for different things. Now you got media degrees and different things that's technology driven that most of our young people are doing. They don't want to go out there in the heat unless you say, like you say, unless you got fathers and mothers that's like, hey, I don't give a hell what you want. Get your ass out there and do it. You can go ahead and do the other shit when you finish your chores. And that's how shit go. But they don't have that no more, man. People just want to chill. They want to be famous on YouTube or Instagram and all that shit there. They're not trying to do all that. But even all immigrants that, coming to take them jobs that we used to do, or our grandfathers used to do, or fathers, they come and get it because they not living like us where they at. They like, they don't want to work hard and let me go pick that shit up and make that money.
But even with that though, Jew, you talking about, you know, they won't be on Instagram. I know a lot of young niggas on Instagram and they popping because they hustling.
Like, I'm saying they got a driven focus. That's
but
cool,
yeah, I'm saying they hustling. Yeah. But I'm sure even if they not out there doing no manual labor job, I'm sure that they can know how to cut grass. I'm sure they know how to do domestic shit because they got the work ethic to, you know what I'm saying? To
some do.
So, you know, it's funny. The Alchemist.
Man, fuck up some grass.
Look, the Alchemist said,
I don't give a fuck you fuck it up, boy, but you're going to get out there and cut it.
Cut that shit.
You see what I'm saying?
What to say, Kurt?
No, I'm saying it's using our tax dollars to subsidize, you know, income. You
hey,
know,
that's what Martin Luther King got killed for telling y'all. Y'all ain't remember that?
They
putting an economic base behind their fucking peasants that they sending over here. That's what the government is a foreign government, and it's taking care of foreigners. That's what they do. Like we have to realize that and move accordingly. Like we not only gotten pushed out of through time, got pushed out of certain labor forces. We got pushed out of certain industries,
right?
Like certain completely industries, farming, you know what I'm saying? Transportation, you know, security. Like most of those were
right, bro.
Prominently brothers owning those fucking industries. You know what I'm saying? Even the construction, we did all of the work, bro. Up into the 50s, up, you know what I'm saying? The 70s and 80s, bro. Like historically, but you know what I'm saying? Like, not enough of us are being like when you got one guy who's a construction guy, you that's okay. But when you got 10 that's doing major contracts, that's providing, you know, a community of people with jobs and with opportunity, it's a whole lot different. You know what I'm saying? Ain't no reason Bo Brothers should still own most of the fucking construction jobs in New Orleans, in Southern Louisiana. Ain't no reason Lemoyne Construction is still fucking kicking ass in Southern Louisiana and Baton Rouge. You know what I'm saying? It got a lot of niggas who swing hammers, but they don't put their businesses together to be able to compete with them. You see what I'm saying?
The industry. It's too real back home, man. They got that on lock in a way that I think they. I mean, the stories I'd have heard on how, you know,
it's by default. It's by default. Fuck being treated. You can't compete with Bo Brothers, Lil Kurt Construction.
I agree. That's what I'm saying. I'm agreeing with you. I'm agreeing with you 100%.
Lil Kurt Construction, Goody 808 Construction, Hatchback Construction, Jewelry Construction. You see what I'm saying? Like, we got the equipment, we got the capital, we got the know-how, we got the versatility, we got the manpower to compete with Bo Brothers for building the fucking Superdome. You see what I'm saying?
We gotta come together, brother.
Or the new prison. Or another bridge, or whatever the fuck it is.
I mean, but here's the thing, man. If I think under those circumstances, our folks need to be able to understand how we appeal to one another to make that businesses come together so that we could not be afraid of dealing with each other in the same ways we've always been, right? Yeah. Thinking that only one of us can make it.
Bro,
listen. Once we get past that, I think we'll be all right.
The fucking Italians did not want to work. They did not work together, but they still was on the same thing to where the niggas gonna eat after us. See what I'm saying? Like, they it's infighting. That's just culture. I'm saying that ain't supposed to stop the bread.
Right.
But it does. And that's what I'm saying. Until we get past it,
let's start motivating each other to say, you know what I'm saying, let's work through our problems. Let's just work through our problems.
Say, bro, I like when y'all be passionate about a particular round. You know,
yeah, we gotta go. Mix it up.
Yeah. We definitely gotta go get into the mix. But I like that.
Do good black business. Do good business, man.
Yeah, I agree. Treat people right, and you're gonna keep customers, and you're gonna grow your clientele.
And knowledge is key. They say if you want to hide something from a nigga, put it in the book. Pick up a book, man.
Hey. Y'all see
a skill set, something.
Yeah, learn a skill
set. Good vibes.
all goes down.
My name is Victoria. I specialize in knotless braids, feed-in braids, and also locks.
Hello, my name is Courtney. I want their experience to be wonderful from the time that they walk in to the time that they leave and seeing that beautiful smile when they go out the door.
What I like about working at Blessed Hands, that we're all just really sisters.
If you can't weave it, we can cheat it. If you cannot grow it, baby, we can sew it.
Hi, my name is Tosha, and I'm the owner of Blessed Hands Beauty Salon. We've been established since 2019. We specialize in all things hair, far as natural styles, protective styles, weaving, wigs, lashes. I love working with all the stylists here because we all like a big family. We support each other and we got each other back.
This is Brandon from A-Fund Solutions, and for a limited time, we're offering free credit restoration services. Click the link down below to get started.
Give me the green light, I've been waiting for too long. Send me the address, I ain't staying for too long. Give me the green light, I've been waiting for too long. Send me the address, I ain't staying for too long.
You ain't staying, you ain't show me.
Wait, pause, stop, let's take a photo. Get that money by any means.
Yo, Yeah. Get that money by any means.
Hey, this is kind of crazy because all of this had the same theme.
All of it. It was perfect. Falling. Look, it was perfect.
Falling.
Bad feet. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You got bad feet. You see what I'm saying?
Flew underneath that. Yeah.
The first dude, when he got stung by a bee or something, like he had like swatting at bees or something. Like why the fuck he jumped off the
stage? I don't know, but he let go of that bit.
Dog. First off, I'm hoping he was on the way up before you really start getting to it. Right. You gotta climb get to the level to
man, yeah, people they was doing this.
Like he was still falling.
Yeah.
If we were falling through clouds, nigga. Oh, poor thing.
Yeah. Then the chick, you know what I'm saying, on the sidewalk, slid smooth off that bitch. She said, I'm talking about
the one that did the split?
No, the one who was sleep. Yeah. Melted off that bitch.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So
slipped down that little slope.
Not the one who did a split.
That was funny, though.
That's a hip injury right there. I see that.
I'll fall.
That's dislocated here. Look, yeah. I tell y'all get 30, 40. Y'all want dance, shake y'all ass, but y'all want stretch the fucking hips.
And the hips stretched out now. I know
she just didn't let it happen, dog. She let it, it was just slow.
Like it.
Let it happen. Oh, it happened like that. Look, she grabbed the back of our shit like this.
Split that. That's a hip right there.
She out of there.
Then,
I knew wrestling was fake.
Shaking like booty meat, huh?
Oh, yeah.
I knew wrestling was fake, but goddamn. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, you got to stretch your hamstrings. Bitch, you all tight running down that ramp.
Leg got heavy on him.
Last two steps.
He dove under that bit. Oh, shit. Like this.
Hope you weren't the one was supposed to win.
For real.
Look, I was out of the gym for about good, I say, 2.5 years, bro. Fucking around. You know what I'm saying? On some ego juice, just bullshitting. The nigga talking about, yeah, man, let's play some flag football. Look, I started off good, just playing quarterback. Then the devil got my fucking ear. You know what I'm saying? You say, bro?
Yes.
The bar took off good. See, about the 10 good steps, I did just what that motherfucker did. Ran dead into the ground. Boom, boom, boom. The last 3 steps, boy.
Everything got heavy, huh?
Cool. Look, I got up. I should have went sat the fuck down. Or went back to quarterback.
Boom. Went back out there.
Went back out there, blew my calf smooth the fuck out.
Damn.
Ooh.
Pop. I thought a motherfucker hit me with a stick or something.
Damn.
My son, hey, I think you pop your Achilles. But I'm reaching on that, no Achilles still left. But that fucking calf was loose than a bitch.
Ooh. Damn. I ain't never heard of that.
Man, look, good you don't look. Don't stretch and try to play some hustle or some shit like that.
Ooh.
Right now.
They talking that shit at the job on the slick.
Man, tell them niggas, man. Look, you got to ease into that shit.
Man, look, Ed, I know my limit. Now I'm spotting up. I'm in the corner, bitch. I don't move.
I'm not even doing that. unless I done stretch for about 30 minutes. I'm talking about warm. I'm warm.
See, I don't really be playing no sports like that, but if I did, I'm at the... You don't want no titty calves. You don't want the titty calf.
Nah, you don't want no titty calf, but you don't want no fucking meniscus at no 43.
Titty calves. Hey, man.
Shit. Yeah,
look, you still about the boxing legs.
Good. You still got to go to work. You still got to go to work.
Oh no! I'm not risking it all, boy. No.
you fucked up. You got to paint this whole fucking hallway.
I'm secure. Look, I'm secure in knowing what I used to could do. I ain't tripping, nigga. Dog, look.
That Grinch just get you something. Get you better sometime. Nigga be talking that good shit. Bitch ass nigga. Hold on.
Yeah, they ain't talking that jazzy, but they is talking about getting out there. We got a dude, he about 40 at the job, too. You know, he hoop on a regular. So he talking.
It be the young niggas. The young niggas be one talking.
See, man, look, Tim right there. You feel me? Tim talking. So I ain't about to risk it, boy.
Tim got gray in his beard. I ain't scared of no nigga with gray in his beard. I'm talking about.
I told him before. He looked like, yeah,
Yeah, man, Tim go to sleep at 10 o'clock. I ain't worried about no nigga that go to sleep early. Look, I'm talking about the nigga that be out all night and still be there for work and still be, you know what I'm saying? Them,
I know who to call, dog. I know who to call.
Them days gone.
Them days are all gone. I used to be
bad. I done already sized y'all up, Hat. You know what I'm saying? I got something for Tim, baby. I got you, boy. Look, phone call the week.
That ain't no win, man. You can't even talk shit to an old nigga. He just gonna say, nigga, fuck, we old, nigga.
Boy, look.
Oh, but your boy, man, I know that nigga ain't got no chin or lips.
I know. When he hit that fall, that ground.
Hit that guy, man.
He jumped up. Oh, yeah.
Ground. Snatched that shit clean off his face. Yeah. First of all, bitch, you ain't some Stacey Adams.
I knew it was coming.
That's some fucking... Some fucking what, Indian penny loafers.
Oh,
you ain't in some skinny jeans.
And then his look was—he was astonished that it happened.
Man, you got some slick. Why the fuck? No sport dressed like that. No sport. Any sport. No, they be like, in some shit they can move thing. In. Not no that's shit like thing. This.
He was confident.
Man, you seen a nigga try to jump over the car on the court? And miss this shit. Bitch, you trying to jump on a over the bike with some skinny jeans and some
with good grip. He missed
some animal balance, bitch.
And them niggas ain't your partners. Yeah.
Well, they was in the background.
Yeah.
Yo. This nigga got on some Daniel Greens, bro. Try to fucking jump.
That's the first thing I looked at, bro. When I seen the shit, I'm like, what he got on his feet? When I seen the slip ins, oh yeah, dog, you tripping.
Well, it looked like he's gonna be on the last car.
And like what? Like I just wanna know what was going on. Like, are you supposed to be getting married or something? You know what I'm saying? Like,
oh, nah, that looked like a challenge.
What's the festivity?
Yeah, that was like a challenge. Yeah,
the nigga, they look like they're celebrating the man. You know what I'm saying?
He tore down. I bet you $200 you can't jump over this shit. Let's go, fuck it.
No, no,
Man, that is.
You got
to. No, stay with me. Fuck it. I got this shit.
Hey, look, it's all in good fun. We can make
fun of
you understand? Because we make fun of each other and everybody else. It's all fucking good.
Yeah.
Don't y'all be writing, talking about fucking wrong podcast, no goddamn anti. Got it.
We
love all y'all.
Love the one who fell off the bike last episode. Yeah.
Yes. But look, y'all gonna have to start getting better at hygiene when y'all trying to serve people food on the streets and shit. That shit is fucking terrible.
Oh, you remember that one clip when that nigga was just handing everything,
Oh, man, it's sweating. Come on.
Ooh. What's up again?
And then a bitch got a nerd that won't have an attitude. Sitting there cutting the meat with his toenails. Bitch.
Ooh, shit, man.
Don't give nigga parasites and fucking... You know what I'm saying?
Boy, you got the fucking flying. Yeah, boy. Whew. Good shit, fellas. We got one more before we get out this bitch. I was gonna hold it for Cub, but Cub, we gonna have to catch you on the flip side. Hey, bro.
Tim, don't take it personal, bro. I'm saying you ain't no threat, not because you can't ball, nigga. You shit shot, man. You done.
Oh shit, man. Y'all keep it locked, man. Hatchback, Jew, Kurt Dog, myself. This is the last one, man.
Can Kobe had to hang it up. Huh?
Shit, right. Oh, boy, it's over.
You talking about snitching, nigga. Pow! I remember how you and Wallow would cry. You and Wallow would cry. Oh, my son. Oh, my son. Hold on. I'm going to call my son. You got to go to the graveyard to see your son. Say, look, this is what my kids give me for Father's Day. Gilly, say, Gilly, cash money backup single. Say, cash money backup single. I'm sorry, backup dancer. Say, listen, I'm finna call my boy, because you can't call yours. You got to do this. Oh, I miss my son. I don't miss my boy. I'm finna call mine right now. Hold on, let me call
you.
All right. Say, Gilly, you want to hear your son's voice just one more time? But pow, they shot the kitchen. Oh, daddy. Oh, you didn't get to help him. You too busy trying to play street and gangster, and your son got killed trying to play gangster. Bang, bang, nigga. Rest in peace.
What you doing now, bro?
Well, they mad that I'm saying fuck somebody dead, but they wasn't mad when they were saying fuck your baby, so I'm mad.
I know, right?
They, when they were saying all this about your baby, what was you doing? You was pleading and crying.
Yeah, I'm to get them to stop. You right, brother.
And to this day, ain't nobody apologized to you.
At all.
Gilly, Jay-Z, nobody from the industry have called and tried to make it right with you.
Not at all, bro.
So they better not say nothing to me till they make it right with you.
Thank you, brother. I love you so much.
I love you too, mama. They better not say a motherfucking thing to me till they make it right with you, mama.
I understand, bro. That's right. Ain't nobody apologized to me or reached out or nothing.
That's all I wanted, mama. I'll call you later.
Okay.
All right.
All right.
My nigga, don't y'all say nothing to me. Don't y'all say nothing to me.
Call her.
Get in touch with her and talk to her, nigga. They slaughtered her baby and wrapped about it and made millions. They got a mural of King Von. And Wally and Gillo laid next to them demons and admired them, homie. Don't say nothing.
All right, Backgrounds Podcast. Benjamin, that's Kurt Dahl. Had you. Fellas, Charleston White, going at Gilly. Apparently, Gilly called him a snitch. And then you saw his initial statements and then his justification for the statements. You know what I'm saying? In my opinion, sucker shit, because I feel you can handle the shit better. You know what I'm saying? But to each his own. Let me get y'all spell on it, and we'll kind of toss it around the room, and we'll get out this bitch. Juve, holler at me.
Yeah, that was some, the way he presented that shit wasn't cool. I get the narrative, what he's trying to do, and, you know, like, they didn't give a fuck, so why should he? I get it, you know what I'm saying? But at the same time, yeah. Gilly's son didn't deserve it either, you know, whatever. I don't know what he was doing out there. Well, I don't know them, so, but nevertheless, it's just the presentation on how he did it. It just could have been done a little bit more tasteful. I know in return, he probably gonna say the same thing about things that's out there in the industry and out in the world. It could have been a little bit more tasteful. You're killing people, kids, and the people, kids losing fathers and uncles, brothers, whatever. But yeah, I think that was just a little grimy right there.
What you got, Hat?
He without sin, let him cast the first stone. I'ma say. Look, so it's kind of funny. Well, you say he did it a little tasteful. First of all, you gotta remember who we talking about.
Right, right.
All right. Now, this nigga is used to showing you a mirror.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? You could talk when your hands clean. When your hands ain't clean, you can't fucking have nothing to say because somebody gonna.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's that's always that. Now, when it come to that shit, you know, I say, like Gilly and Wallo, they play that street shit, right? They talk all that about this and old when they used to do this and try to. You know what I'm saying? Like they put on that persona. Now, I'm not saying that it's right for him to say that, but if Ren right. was here, he would back me up in saying that you can't tell me how to get my fucking lick back. You understand what I'm saying? It's like when you call a person a snitch, especially in certain cultures, that's you saying something. You really giving a charge. You see what I'm saying? You call a man a pedophile, you call a man a snitch. That could bring harm to this man. You see what I'm saying? So when you say that, now I'm going to bring harm to you. You feel me? When I was younger, they learned early, don't try to like talk shit to me. Because I'm the type of person, I was always cerebral with it. I took it personal. Nigga be talking about this, talking about that, and I hit it with something like, I look, you know, we be in a group of people, you know what I'm saying? And I'll be like, say, dog, hold on. Let me ask you something. I asked somebody else, what you ate for dinner last night? Nigga said, what he ate for dinner. I asked another nigga, what you ate for dinner last night? Yeah, what Jay, okay. I ate this, whatever, pork chop, whatever. Nigga, tell us what you ate. I already know what he ate. You ain't ate nothing. Why? Your mama strung out. Y'all walking out. You see what I'm saying? I hit you with the life shit. And it wasn't cool at the moment. Nobody was laughing. They was really feeling bad for dude. And then, like, we probably wound up fighting and shit, but I didn't play fair when it came to that shit. You see what I'm saying? You can't tell me how to come back at you with taste and with all that. You tried to ruin me and call me, you know what I'm saying, something that you know is offensive in our culture.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I came back at you with some heat. And fuck how you feel about it. Because, like he said, y'all bigging up in this and bigging up the lifestyle and shit. And when it happens, you act like you so whatever. You wasn't saying, oh, my son, right, when he was out fucking running around. So, I mean, I don't feel bad for him. I think it's shitty that they doing this. But, I mean, he just another one. You know what I'm saying? When it come to Gilla and Wilder, like, won't they stop fucking with that dude? Because he not, like, it ain't, you know what I'm saying? Like, you not.
Right.
What you expect?
Yeah.
What's your guy, Kirk?
Well, I'm not really sure why they called him a snitch. I don't know if it really matters or not, but.
You never heard nothing about what he did?
Who?
Charleston White.
I thought he was just well, I guess so.
Yeah, they call the nigga Rat Williams.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. Well, the point of the matter is, I mean, if you make your living doing a certain thing, and if you live that lifestyle and you know what that thing is, and if you being a rat is something that's detrimental to your lifestyle. But you make your lifestyle like that, then I mean, I don't think that, like you said, knowing who he is will it really matter of how he delivered. He gonna deliver it for the most impact, right? He's gonna deliver
right.
it to make sure that people hear him. Now, if they get the message or not, I'm not really sure. And I heard what he was trying to say, like, you know. He without sin cast the first stone, came, you know, the pot calling the kettle black. But I mean, is that really, I mean, who's this person he was hiding behind? Why did he have to use that person to prove his point? Who was the person he called in the phone?
That was,
what's called Mama.
I probably, yeah,
Toonchi, I don't know how to say the name.
One of them rappers, Mama. One of
them. One of them that was. Killed
because look, he reached out to a lot of Motri Mama, all of these women. He was trying to reach out to them and comfort them or whatever. When all of these motherfuckers, like he said, making songs about killing them and this and that and the third and fuck them and all of this other shit. How y'all gonna, you know, do that type of shit and then pull a Bone Thugs and cry at the crossroad, bitch. All the niggas you done killed in the double Glock, murder, more murder, more murder, and then you miss your Uncle Charles Jones, bitch, fuck you.
So it is the thing, though, dog.
People like, just mad at his delivery then. It is what it is, man.
But but that's the thing, like, I haven't heard Gilly respond to none of the shit. To me, this is just the backlash he be getting from the people, so you justified it with calling a mama and then explaining ultimately, like head saying you're showing a mirror. And though some, you know, the reflection could be true and, you know, what's being seen. Like if you a known snitch and you running with that and right. you know what I'm saying? That's what it is. Then are you really that offended when I call you a snitch?
Right.
Or is this just another ploy for you to, you know what I'm saying, clicks going and some more shit?
You ran into the shit. You stepped in quicksand.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like you just gave him some shit to fire off about. Because he on that bitch talking about he the Tupac of this shit. He on the internet. So, you know what I'm saying? Like to me.
Venus flytrap, bro.
It's fucked up what he said to me. You know what I'm saying? It's fucked up. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but, he meant it to be.
Nigga, like, You doing look, that shit just because nigga opened the door, kind of. You feel
nigga,
me? Like,
look, you, look yeah, when you in the club, nigga will put on some fresh white shoes, hoping a nigga step on that bitch so he could knock his fucking block off. Knowing you ran into it, bro. I mean, shit.
Right.
Yeah, like, to me, because, yeah, you, like, to me, I don't listen to a lot of Charleston, but I feel like he didn't. He's confessed to being the snitch. Like, nigga, that's what I do. I call them people. You feel me? I'm going to call them right now. Is he that just a, set niggas is, up.
But is that a... See what I'm saying? The snitch shit, that shit don't even...
Oh, not nah, hat. Like, the shit could be definitely blurred, huh? You know.
It ain't blurred. It's
shit,
fucked
it
up.
It is blurred. That's nigga calling niggas snitches. Ain't even snitch.
Nigga, you that's what I'm saying. That's not a civilian thing. We civilians, bro. That's a street thing. That's an in cahoots thing. Nigga, we gotta be fucking around for me to snitch on you. You understand what I'm saying? Like, that ain't even a nigga.
Yeah, to a certain degree, but
they don't even want,
you know, I ain't gonna split them halves.
Oh, if a nigga do you something, they don't even want you to call the police. They say that snitching. Nigga, did you something? You can't even tell.
And that's why I say sometimes the shit be blurred, you know what I'm saying? Because at this point, everybody interpreting shit the way they want to for their benefit. Right. You know what I'm saying?
The snitches, right. Okay, see this YSL shit, the RICO shit, the all of that shit? Yeah, it's some snitching going on with that. Because that was, you see what I'm saying?
That's what we grew up to know it to be. You know
what I'm
saying?
That's what it is. If a motherfucker call the police because somebody is outside of his house at 2 a.m. playing the fucking music loud, that's a snitch. Get your bitch ass from around. You don't live around here, man. Get the fuck around here. That's a snitch.
So I hear what you're saying. So you're saying basically, in order for someone to be considered or labeled a rat, a snitch, it's not necessarily that they're informing the authorities on what you did wrong. It's that you was in with them and you called the authorities.
That's a street word. That's a gangster word. Yeah. That's an organized crime word. A rat is somebody who, you see what I'm saying?
You're in the nest.
But you involved, but you... You bring
you're involved, but you still kind of feeding information.
Yeah, that's not a civilian word.
Right. I got you. I see what you're saying. I get that's why the line is blurred or what you're
right.
saying. That's how people
But they try to pull that shit on the community. They pull that shit on the community. These, you know what I'm saying? These stupid motherfuckers, you know, this gang shit. And they, you know, no rap. Man, y'all do that dumb ass shit. We ain't into this shit.
Just the whole
keep that shit over there.
Get stitches shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you ain't gonna intimidate me. That's what I'm saying. What? You ain't gonna intimidate me.
Nigga, they really program that in your head and you should be saying something.
They try to intimidate you. They try to shame you. Like, they try to, you know what I'm saying? Because they fucking up. Yeah. They don't want you to, man, go on about your business.
That's crazy.
It is crazy.
Hey, fellas, good shit. We ain't too far.
Okay. One more thing. Good. I'm going to make it. I promise I'm going to make it fucking fast.
What you say?
Nah. We could talk about snitches. I'm just throwing it out there. I'm not no conspiracy theories or none of that shit. Just when shit line up, I'm just got to show what it. I'm seeing. All right. They say Lil Meech had a fucking interview last week or so, whatever. I seen it. He said that Big Meech will be home soon.
Mm-hmm.
Right. 9 months or whatever.
Yeah.
Okay. Immediately afterwards, Puff Daddy goes down. Boom. He got a drug mule that's carrying liquid cocaine. Boom. Puff Daddy used to be with Big Meech now. Boom. Puff Daddy, right-hand man, Wolf, got killed by fucking Big Meech them in Atlanta after they'd had a riff. You see what I'm saying? Not Big Meech coming home, Puff Daddy going to jail. Does any of this, is it all wrapped up together? I'm just saying, like, does any, like.
Now that you said it, I mean, yeah.
I'm just throwing things out there. Like, you know what I'm saying? I'm not accusing or nothing. But
who knows?
Like,
something to think about, you know what I mean? I'm just saying.
It's a lot there, you know what I'm saying? It's kind of loaded, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I don't make it, I just report the news, bro.
I could definitely see how we could put it together, you know what I'm saying? Nah, do it all actually fit? Shit, we gonna see in a hot minute.
Time will tell.
Yeah, we about to see in a hot minute. But I do definitely I like that one. There's something for y'all to ponder on as y'all wait for us to come back Monday. You know,
don't get mad at me. I don't want to hear no shit in the comments. You know what I'm saying? I'm get fucking mad at. I just report, man.
Nah, you gonna get a little shit in the comment, but it's
oh all, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Before we get out the door, get these shots out. Shouts out to the OG Sites. Appreciate you, nigga. Cuz O'Ren. Where you at? Bye.
Yeah, boy.
Damien. Miss Lyric. Timbo. G-Man. The Alchemist. Franny T. Miss Minor. Did I? And shouts out to old behind the scenes B.
Sites, I need one of them big boy t-shirts, my guy.
Sites?
I need one of them big boy record t-shirts, man.
For Kurt Dog, Juve, a.k.a. Nino, Hatchback of the ENT, myself, Benjamin Nett, shouts out to Uncle Neff, the Rhymes Podcast. We catch y'all Monday. Out the door. All right.